Last I remember, we were planning to take the long rest at
right,
the
heading back
inn.
To town.
Oh, yeah. So you had gone back to Nightstone, yes?
We were kind of en route back to Nightstone, I think, or we were, maybe we got, you know, this is not specific. I think we had decided that we were going to head back and have a rest, as Darks was saying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. That's cool. So I think you'd saved some townspeople, yeah?
Yep.
Definitely.
We had.
Let me pull up this map here and pull up where we're up to. Shared.
Saved some people, went to an inn, owned by a dwarf.
But you'd left the rest of the cave unexplored because you'd taken some serious wounds rescuing the townsfolk from the two ogres and the collection of goblins you'd found and fought off on the ledges.
Mm-hmm.
And you travelled back to the town of Nightstone and had proceeded to have a long rest. I think Morak, the bloke, might have offered you a place in his inn, or if he hadn't, he certainly did. You guys stay in the inn of Morak for a couple hours first, getting yourself together, helping the townspeople unpack. It's still early in the afternoon, so having a sleep is not ever present on your mind. So everyone at least gets a long rest. Let me just delete Lop with a billion HP so you can get him off. Chip is the rat and Chip is gone. So after a short rest, it's starting to get later into the afternoon, and the townsfolk have started to clean up their houses, clean up the mess and start gathering the dead to offer the burial rites. Did Soranti already do that and help them?
Yep. I was 100% enthusiastic of helping the local priest in performing any ceremonies that need
That's right.
to take place.
Sorry, it's been a long week.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So we can consider that you guys help with the afternoon, help with burials, help with gatherings. And as night begins to fall and you all start settling down in the inn, perhaps having a free meal or a free drink offered to you by the innkeeper, Morak, for being so helpful in getting the town people safe and starting to help with the cleanup. You guys get some free meat or dried meat and stale bread. That's all he really has to offer at the moment. But ale by the plenty. Which sweetens it up a nice bit. After enough ale, any food starts tasting pretty delicious.
Mm-hmm.
So, as it begins to crawl into the evening, is anyone not sleeping? Is anyone out? Is anyone wanting to do something other than head straight to bed and sleep through the night?
I would be taking first watch.
Okay. So where do you want to watch? Yes. You just want to watch
anything?
The inn, or are you wanting to head out of town and watch, or to the guard posts, perhaps?
I would be at the guard post, the one with the drawbridge, just making sure, the one on the west.
Yeah, okay.
Yep.
So you can sort of see who's approaching. Obviously, the drawbridge is pulled up for the evening. Mm-hmm. There's no reason to have it open through the night, so the townsfolk and the remaining guards that are still alive have pulled the drawbridge up. So you have a pretty decent view of anyone that would approach, and the drawbridge is secured, as it were.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So who's taking... What are the orders of the watch? Now, it doesn't matter about time. I don't consider that watch costs you your sleep. I just want to know who is watching when.
I'm taking my watch on the roof of the inn.
I'll take last watch. Jimmy will do last watch.
Okay, and you're watching at the tower or the inn?
Oh, I'll watch at the tower.
All right.
I'll take the second watch.
Okay, so we'll do Soranti, Siduri... I guess Adrian slots in there at the middle.
Slots in there. Yep. Yeah.
And then Darkson on the roof of the inn, and then Jimmy taken last.
Why don't we chuck that into the watch order list on the party sheet so we never have to discuss it again?
That's a good point. So
yeah.
One. Jimmy last. There we
cool.
go.
Cool.
Excellent. All right. We'll never, ever ask that again. Thank the Lord.
It takes so much time.
I know. And your rest is over.
It does, though. People do that. It becomes this big issue for some reason, and it's pathetic.
The worst thing is, like, you spend half an hour doing it, and then the GM's like, and the night passes without incident.
That's right.
So, with your watch set up, and you all deciding who's going to be going when and where, the night passes without incident. No. So, about 2 hours into your watch, Savranti, could I please get a perception check? Just one.
Of course.
Regular
sleep. Do you want me to roll that in tower?
Yes, if you could. That'd be great.
All right. Still pretty used to that, but... Watch this be like a fucking two.
A two is less than what you rolled. I'll give you that much.
Great.
It's a three.
Hey, I didn't say how much you rolled. It could be anywhere from 3 to 20. You never know. So you're watching out the tower, and it is pretty pitch black. Pitch black? Pitch black.
Block.
And dark. Dark beyond sort of 20 or 30 feet. There's a little bit of light from each of the guard towers. There's a fire burning at the top that projects light from behind you, so you can sort of see out without ruining your night vision. And you catch a glimpse of something just at the very edge of your vision, just for a moment, maybe like a glint of steel or a flash of light. And you look again and you try and see what it was, but you don't really see anything for a few moments. Do you want to do anything, or you just want to continue your watch?
Well, I'm absolutely am not bringing down the bridge to go out there, but I'll yell out, "Hold there!" If I see something,
you call out into the darkness. And
yeah.
No one calls back, but after a few moments, you hear from the tower opposite you, "Hello?" And you see a little guard that's looking over, trying to see who called out. "Are you talking to me?"
"I thought I saw something in the woods. Did you see anything?"
Sort of looks out, furrows his brow a bit. "I don't see anything. What did you see? What do you think you saw?" And then,
"Don't worry yourself about it."
As you're replying to him, you hear, and an arrow catches the guy right in the side of the neck, and he stumbles, holding his throat, and then falls from the tower onto the ground between the two.
Great. So he's most likely dead.
Quite possibly, yes.
Would I know that Draxon is on the roof?
No, because it's not his watch yet either. So you're the only one that's currently out. He'll be later on in the evening. He'll be on the roof, unless Draxon was wanting to stay through the whole night and forgo his long rest.
Mostly, I've taken my long rest on the roof.
Okay, so he's asleep for all intents and purposes then. Just then there's another arrow clinks just onto the stonework next to you, and then another one flies in through the window that you're standing next to and hits a wall on the other side, sticks in. You see a gnarled, bent and twisted arrow, not finely crafted at all, horribly damaged feathers on the back for its guiding feathers, and another one flies through the window, but you've ducked out of the way at this time, and arrows are just raining down on the guard tower. There's still no noise other than the of the arrows flying through.
I'm going to get out of the guard tower and I'm going to yell to Draxon to wake up the others. We're under attack.
All right. You yell that out down the town square. Could I please get a dexterity saving throw from you?
Does it have to be dexterity?
It certainly does. I apologize.
All right. Not terrible.
Not terrible. Not great, but not terrible. As you're getting out of the room in the guard tower, the top room, to run downstairs and shout, there's a huge explosion of fire in the top room as some magical force causes the fire to explode that's in there. And it explodes out. You get caught for only half damage, so you only take... you take 8 points of fire damage, and you manage to duck out... Oh, resistant? 4 points of fire damage, nice. So, you take 4 points of fire damage and duck down out of the building just in time to see all the flames billowing out of the windows for a few moments more. You hear some shrieks coming from the town square, and you shout down, "Daxon, wake up!" And Daxon, can I get a perception check because you're asleep? See if this wakes you.
In the tower,
Just roll it. Yeah, we know what's trying to get your attention, so we don't need the tower.
Mm-hmm.
Nope.
So if he doesn't wake up, I'm basically going to break down the door to the inn and wake everyone up that way. Just yelling into the inn to wake up.
All right. So you start running the distance from the wall. Let me just put you on the map here. Put you back on. You guys are all going to be in the inn. Darkson, who I'll put on the roof here. Okay, so you guys are considered inside the inn right now, and you will start running from the guard tower. So you're obviously going to dash. You're not going to do anything.
Nope, I'm doing nothing but dashing.
Right. So the distance you have just dashed puts the arrows. Oh, they'll be at disadvantage, I think.
Well, can they see me?
Who knows? 120.
That is a point.
All right. So as you're running, arrows begin to pepper the streets all around pretty indiscriminately. You see a whole bunch of flame-lit arrows landing in houses and against the wall of the guard tower behind you and landing all over the ground. None of them find their mark on you, thankfully. But you see the church, the temple just next to you. About 5 or 6 arrows have landed on the roof, and you see them begin to burn through the sort of thatch roof that this temple has on it, or this wooden roof. But you manage to make your way beyond the range from then. You manage to make your way to the inn and smash open the door, kicking it open, waking up everyone, certainly, with the kicking through the door and the shouting. Everyone can now be considered awake and alert. There's also townspeople running throughout the town, beginning to help firefighting and sort of numbers confused coming out of the houses, out of the other places where people have been taking refuge, such as the staples of the temple itself. So what do you say to the group?
I'm basically yelling out at them, "We're under attack. Get ready." And I'll move back to, I think it's 30 feet. Yeah. To there so that I have a good angle of the drawbridge and also the bridge down south, at least.
Okay. So, could I get everyone to roll initiative for me?
Hmm. Oh, good.
Excellent. So, you start to move towards the square. Everyone else is sort of moving and getting themselves ready. Adrian, I don't know why yours didn't... Oh, I know why.
I was just trying to work. I'm not sure why that didn't work.
It's because the one on the combat tracker is the one I deleted, I believe.
Ah.
So it was linked to the other sheet. There you go. So, you all can sort of freely move a turn now. You can get a free movement and a free action. If you want to prepare anything, mage armor, etc., etc.
We have the effects of our rest already, or are we still...
You've had the effects of a short rest. This is still very early in the evening. It's still during Soranti's watch, so you guys haven't had the full effects of your long rest, though you have had my goodness, my mouth isn't working today. You have had a short rest, so if you needed to spend any hit dice, Soranti, I think you're the only one with wounds. You can do that for your short rest.
I can't see me on the combat tracker, by the way.
So that's a bug right now. You are there, so don't worry about that. Okay. Just use the the map if you need to.
Yeah, no worries.
So I think I still have the effects of my mage armor from I don't know how long it's been, but
okay. Do you want to recast it, or do you want me to remove that?
It may still be in effect. I'm not sure. You know, you have to tell me if it's been more than 8 hours. Is it 8 hours that takes effect for? From when we put it on, when I put it on.
Oh yeah, it is 8 hours. Yep, it'll still be good then. You'll still have several hours left on it. For some reason, I thought it was an hour in my head. I was wrong.
Okay, and Chip is also still with us.
The rat? Excellent.
The rat.
The rodent.
Yeah. That little rat.
Okay. I haven't had a chance to change him into something more useful right now.
Hey, rat. Maybe I will.
Yeah. Well, I'm thinking that, you know, maybe I'll take 10. Well, I don't know. If I had 10 minutes here, I could change him into an owl.
You would have had 10 minutes of your break right now. You can change him if you want to change him into an owl.
Okay.
Darkson, what are you doing? Are you coming down from the roof?
Absolutely.
Okay, so that's going to take 15 feet of your movement to hop down from the roof. So you'll have...
Long jump, or
climbing down from the roof. Or do you just want to leap off?
Leap off.
Okay, make an acrobatics check.
Long jump wise.
Do you want to run in a straight line off the roof and see what happens? Go for it. All right, so you leap off and stumble a bit, but catch yourself, not really costing any movement, and you run along to the front end of town, by the looks. All right, we go to Jimmy.
I'll run down there and can I see anything yet, or is it just
you can see the arrows that are burning around? There's probably 20 or 30 arrows sticking to buildings, into ground, and into the guard tower. Some of them, especially the ones at the temple, seem to have people already running there with buckets of water to stop it putting out. So it's not an immediate threat just yet. But a follow-up volley would certainly exacerbate things. You can see that they all seem to have come from the direction where the drawbridge lowers as well.
Okay, well, I'll move 5 more feet that I've got, and I'll crouch down behind Soranti, trying to show that I'm not using him for cover.
All right.
Totally not using.
You
him
hide
for
behind
cover.
The tank.
That's right.
I mean, that's nothing new, and he doesn't take offense of that. He has a shield for him.
There we go. Good stuff.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's my turn.
Sidiri.
He knows his role. Let's say that.
Sorry.
That's right. Not used to people actually knowing where the turn button is. All right, Sidiri, what are you doing?
Okay, well, I'm going to send Chip flying up out over towards the tower.
So he's an owl now, did you say?
Yes, he's an owl now. Okay, so he can move 60.
Shit.
Fly 60 feet, got some dark vision. So, you know, he's going to take a little while before he gets there, before I use my turn to see what he does. But, and then other than that, something, I think I, oh, Adrian.
Chip will fly out, the window. And then where are you wanting him to fly to? So he's about 25 feet out to the road outside.
Yeah, he's got 60-foot speed.
Yeah.
For his turn, I guess if he dashes, I suppose you could do 120 feet on a turn. He's gonna fly towards the tower. I think that's where Sarante. Where did you see the attack come from?
From the woods. Unfortunately, I did not get a specific location. Right. So.
Yeah. So he's gonna go up there and see if he can. You know, fly around and see if you can see anything.
All right. So he does get up to the tower with his dash. Roll me a perception check, please, with his perception, which is a plus one. That's right, plus three,
yeah.
Here's his sheet, by the way.
Nice.
Okay, so you can just completely see through his senses, yeah?
Right, I can spend my action to see through his eyes. Mm-hmm. So that's what I'm doing now. I'm just staying in here, but I am using his seeing through his eyes or his senses.
So you pay attention through his eyes, and as you look out, you can see a number of dark shapes. And amongst the tree line just outside the gate, the owl's eyes are much better at seeing through the dark than everyone else's. And you can make out a good 20 figures moving around. They're large, they're hulking, they're not certainly not goblins. Go ahead and roll me a nature check or a survival check. Whichever one you're better with.
Okay.
Did you say 20?
Yeah, about 20.
Ooh.
Oh, hello.
Oh, all right, 11.
11?
Yep.
If you didn't know better, you'd say that these are orcs.
Okay. All right, so that's my action. Okay, so I can't really do anything with that information right now, I don't think, but
I mean, you can say to everyone, it's a free action to say something if you'd like.
Right.
Just not hold a
Guys,
conversation.
Guys, looks like there's about 20 hulking things over there across in the woods, according to my owl. Could be orcs.
All right. I'm not going to do anything just yet, but what I'm going to do is for a reason.
Yep.
For some reason, I can understand primordial, which I shouldn't, but...
Weird. Yeah, no, there's a few bugs with the language. We had the same issue with Dwarven. Oh, sorry, I just moved you outside.
Draconic.
Tried to drag the move, dragged you out instead. And you're actually behind. Oh, in front of Jimmy. Okay. Yeah, it was Draconic was the other issue, eh? So, Adrian, what are you doing, buddy?
He's basically just gonna move out of the inn, and I think I'm not gonna be able to target anything, so I may as well use a dash as well.
Okay.
And maybe duck in underneath, behind the rock in the middle of the courtyard.
Okay. Getting ready for something to come through these gates.
Yeah, but bow's ready and waiting.
Alrighty. So, a few moments go by, everyone's sort of just waiting for whatever's going to happen. There's no follow-up volley of arrows. there's no more guards in the tower. That one guard that was up there died. You see everyone else is sort of busy trying to put out these fires. No one's thought to come back to the tower. When you see two hooked instruments come flying over the top of the drawbridge, and they sort of latch, two grappling hooks latch onto the top and pull taut at the very top of the drawbridge, and you start to hear some scruff, scraping and scratching on the other side of the drawbridge, and what sounds like various bodies bumping into against it. A few moments go by. Does anyone want to do anything?
Alright. I'm going to run up to Darkson and grapple him.
Okay. You run up and grapple Darkson?
Yes.
I'm going to resist that.
You can try.
Roll contested athletics. So you roll athletics, and Darkson, you can roll athletics or acrobatics.
God damn it. Yes.
One shy. One shy.
So you grab onto Darkson, stopping him from doing whatever he was going to do, probably.
Yeah. I knew exactly what he was going to do. He was going to run up and face these guys by himself, not letting him die today.
All right, so Darkson, your speed is zero.
Hey guys, listen, I got a potential plan later on that you might want to think about, which is I've got web between the towers. Might be a good place for me to lay a whole bunch of web if these guys charge over in the dark.
I would consider over the wall if they're coming over the gate. If they're coming over the gate, then above the gate would be a good idea.
Right. I was thinking if they pull the drawbridge down,
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
No, what if they're planning to come over the wall or over it? Right.
Well, then we'll have to see. But think about that anyway. Think about that. I've got a web spell.
That's one of our best options at the moment. Mm.
That might get a few. If it gets a few of them, you know, caught in there, then they'll be restrained.
Then I can see if my fire breath does anything.
Yeah, well, it does. It burns up the web burns, and they can burn whoever's in the web, evidently.
Yeah, so if you get them clumped up, I would absolutely consider that. But having a little bit of trouble with Draxon at the moment.
Talking of Draxon, sure Draxon, it's died. Your turn. What are you gonna do, buddy? Your speed is currently zero. You can spend an action to try and escape this grapple. But that is your action, of course.
I will try and break it.
All right, so it's another athletics for me.
Yep.
Oh, great. No. He's probably getting away from this, but...
So you meet the DC, which is 9, so you do break free.
Yes.
Oh, what?
Yeah, because he's trying to get out of your grip.
He's I thought met. Ties were, then nothing changes.
I think ties the initiator wins, yeah? Let me have a check. I'll double check.
That was previous editions, from what I understand. I could be wrong, but that's how I've played it before.
That's right. Let's have a look. Actions. Grappling. Escaping a grapple. You can use your action to escape. To do so, must succeed on an athletics check contested by your strength athletics. Contests in combat.
I get the feeling that the DC is set by the DC is set by the person that's actually grappling them.
Let's have a look. There's nothing in the PHP.
At least that's what I feel.
All
Let's not spend forever on this. Yep. If he wants to escape, we'll let him escape. He can die if he wants
to.
We'll go
for it. We'll go for meeting it. He sits at DC.
Just remember that for later.
Hmm. Alright, Daxon, you run off 45 feet by yourself.
And just wait there for now.
That's what I was afraid of, but fair enough.
All right, so Daxon runs off by himself. Jimmy, you see Daxon escape from Soronti's grasp with a sigh. Soronti just sees him runs off. And
okay. So we've still got nothing on the map that we can actually see yet. Who's yet to act? Where are Siduri and where is Siduri?
Siduri is still in the inn.
I'm in the inn.
Edrin is behind the rock just to the south of you.
Okay. Well.
Oh wait, crap! I think I've messed up with an elf thing. With elves getting keen senses. I don't think I have it did that. I messed up with that.
The roll's been rolled. Just remember it for next time. Mm-hmm. So, Jimmy, you move off to the rock as well, taking cover, seeing Edrin hiding behind the rock. That's probably not a terrible idea.
Yeah, I'm going to definitely take cover there. I'm not a frontliner. I'll wait to see if anything happens there before I act.
Okay.
Yep.
All right. Siduri? You can do another action to see out your owl again, if you wish. Try and get a better idea of what they're doing on the other side.
Yeah, I think that's what I'll do. Whatever information we can get. I'm just trying to see if the owl might, maybe it'll fly over a little closer or something.
So,
still pretty high up, though.
Because you're seeing through the eyes, you'll know before it flies over what it sees.
Yeah.
Which is about 20 orcs.
Oh, they're right there.
There's probably 10 that are up near the drawbridge. The ones that are just on the map at the other end of the drawbridge are on the island that's not connected right now, or rather over the land that's not connected. And there's 4 that are climbing up 2 grappling ropes, climbing up the drawbridge that's currently raised. You also see many more orcs in the trees behind that are sort of waiting for something to happen.
Okay.
Do you still want to fly over there, or are you happy? You're happy where you're standing?
Oh, if
you'd see that easily. You don't need to fly for a closer look because these guys are now up against the bridge.
Yeah, he's just gonna fly. He's just gonna fly off and wait in the tree somewhere.
Okay.
Kind of. I don't know. Sort of hiding inconspicuously as another owl out for a nightly mouse hunt. Okay. So that's my turn, and I'm just gonna tell everybody, look guys, quit screwing around with your wrestling and things. This is no time for a wrestling match. We've got about I don't know, my owl just told me you can see already about 8 orcs and 2 of these bigger hulking Norgas, and they're right outside the gate, and there's more coming behind them. So we need to think of something fast in terms of ambushing these guys. Otherwise, I don't know if we can take them, just the 5 of us.
A bloody wrestling match? I was trying to save his bloody life. But you're right. My one and only idea at the moment is to retreat back to the keep, because we cannot take these guys on head on like Draxon is about to do.
Edrin, what do you do? You're hiding behind the rock. You hear Siduri call out that there's about 20 orcs few moments away from breaching that wall.
I haven't got over the wall yet.
No, they're about halfway. There's about 4 that are about halfway.
The grappling hooks.
Yeah.
Okay. So I actually think heading for the keep's not a bad idea, actually. Having said that, I want to stay together with the party. So I think what I'll do, I'm just going to move. I'm just going to move a few feet across to the other stone, the other rock that's in the courtyard for now.
Yep.
And my bow's obviously drawn, ready to fire if they do come over, but equally starting to make a move towards the keep.
Okay. And you voice as much to Cervanti and everyone else who was talking about the keep?
Yeah, absolutely. I tell everybody, I think the keep's the place to go. We can defend it.
All right. So, some of the orcs begin to climb. There's two orcs that leap over the top of the drawbridge and land fully on the other side. One of them reaches into his back and pulls out a sharp-looking two-handed axe and starts snarling and looking around. And begins to move towards the tower's doors. This one here tries to do the same, sees the rock that's in the way, and begins to try and shove it to get into that tower. So the rock begins to roll in its little crater, but doesn't quite go anywhere just yet. And then there is a thing that happens. There is a howl, a roar, a bestial roar coming from the other side. And this guy actually will move over here. And you start to hear the sounds of axes on wood. Sorante, your turn.
All right. Oh, fuck.
Never a truer word been spoken.
Oh, shit.
I God damn it, Draxon. God damn it. Soronte is going to say a prayer for Draxon, because although I'm not for this, I'm not suicidal either. I'm going to yell out to Draxon, "We're headed for the keep. I hope I see you alive." And move down towards the keep.
All right. Make your movement. Are you going to dodge?
Actually, I'm going to hold my movement until Jimmy moves.
All right. Until Jimmy moves. Okay. All right. So, I guess it becomes Jimmy's turn, yeah?
Okay,
no, it's Darkson's turn. Sorry. Cut you off there. Darkson before Jimmy. So, Darkson, what are you doing? The two orcs have just come over the wall. They don't seem to be caring about you standing right there. In a square, but they are sort of making their way to the two towers, which, as you know, hold the chains that lower and raise this drawbridge.
I'm gonna move there within throwing range, and throw a dart at him.
Okay, go ahead and throw a dart. It didn't target anything. Just go ahead and drag that onto the target and then control click him as well.
There we go.
Oh, hang on, we'll take your first attack. You can drag, you've made an attack, you can drag the result onto the target and it'll apply it again. So go ahead and roll damage.
That makes more sense.
And you deal 8 points of damage, max damage dice. The dart sinks into his shoulder. He looks at you, snarls, and you see him just drop the rock and it just rolls back into place. And he looks to be fairly not so ignoring of you anymore. All right, Jimmy.
Okay, so the
wait, okay, I want to use the rest of my movement.
Okay, where do you want to move?
There.
Okay, all right. There we go. Jimmy, your turn.
Yeah, I'll run down to there behind that rock there.
Okay, so Auntie, you can now make your movement if you like.
Mm-hmm. Now, the only thing I did was yell at Draxon, so... yeah, I'll just move to here anyway. Okay. Not gonna dash.
All right. You don't want to dash?
No.
Okay. We go now to Siduri. Your turn.
Right. All right, so right now, where are people going there? Are you guys trying to head to the keep?
Yep.
I yelled out to go to the keep.
It's going to be a foot race with those guys going to the keep.
One that I'll probably win.
You're fast.
Current movement speed, 45.
Keep us updated, mate. I want to know when that changes.
Okay, I will.
Let's see. Well, I could, All right, if we're heading there, I'm dashing. I guess I'll take all the right. Dash move.
You dash out of the tower. This means you've moved yourself back.
Okay, go ahead. So 60 feet, I guess might as well take the maximum dash.
All right, that gets you 60 feet from there. Still behind a bit of cover and catching up with Adrian and Soronti.
Yeah. And Chip is going to fly back, so he stays within range.
Okay. He's going to do a dash, so he can pretty much...
He's going to fly back to the roof over here, so he can...
Oh, nice. Okay, so... that's yours and Chip's turn. Adrian! Everyone's making a beeline for the keep. You heading there too?
Yeah, I am, but I'm gonna take a shot at the orc that was hit by the dart.
All right, give it a shot.
First, and then I'll make my
give it a shot.
Okay. So, and I can use Hunter's Mark, can't I?
As a bonus action, yes, you can cast Hunter's Mark and then make your attack. And he's, you're not level...
And he's injured as well.
Yeah, you are level 3, so you should have that as well.
Yeah, so I can really muller him with a bit of luck. Okay, here goes.
Boom.
Hey.
Okay.
Do it.
So... Do I roll the dice and then do the effects after?
So, if you've got the effects set up, click the effects and then roll damage. If you don't have them set up, just roll the D6 and the D8 separately, and then you can drag those onto your modifier.
You have it, though.
What was that, Sarandi? Oh, there you go. That works. Yep. And you explode him. You fire a shot, and it shoots through and catches him right in the head, and he goes down.
What was the extra D8? Nice,
Colossus Slayer.
Continuing my being pretty chuffed with myself, so nice little smile for myself, and then I'll carry on retreating.
All right, fantastic.
There we go.
All right.
So I move the 35. Okay. And that's my turn, I think.
Yeah. Some more orcs begin to... pile into the back. And this one, let's roll. You hear the splintering and smashing of wood, and you see Norgra One Eye, the named orc, has smashed through the wall to the side. They turn and they roar again, and you see him waving through the hole he's just cut as he then moves further into the town. More orcs piling in behind. They have reached the walls.
Oh my god.
Those are their movements. Sorrente, your turn.
Can I see any civilians?
You see a number of the townspeople.
It's nearby.
Two are on top of the temple, putting out the flames that have taken up there. And you know that there's a handful that had run into the temple and might not have seen that there's orcs coming in.
Oh my god.
There is a lot of orcs there. Yeah, you are very much aware that many orcs is a lethal amount.
It is suicide, but morally, Sorrento
is but
dealing with some...
How much good can you do if you're dead?
It's not about that. It's if I tried, but I'm not suicidal, so I'm gonna run off that. yeah, I'm going to move to here. I'm going to stay as much in between the orcs and the rest of my party that I can see. As much as I can, making sure that if they get up close to us, I'm the first one that they meet, not anyone else.
Okay, so you're bringing up the rear, basically.
Yes.
I'll let you consider your movement. If people move along, you can move along with them. I'll consider that your movement is held to follow them. That's
Yep.
Mechanics shouldn't get in the way of bringing up the rear.
Let's hope.
All right. The orcs on the outside, these ones move up, these ones move in. Two more orcs leap over the top and you hear bangs and scratches again coming from the other side as more orcs hurry to meet their place. Start climbing up the back. One, two,
three. We need to start picking these off, guys.
The moment before they swarmed is lost. More orcs. And the ones that went to the... Actually, one died. This one goes to the rock and begins to move it. This one gets into the tower, and you hear him crashing around inside the tower. And then you see the chain just sort of fly out broken, and the bridge starts sagging onto the other chain that's holding it up now. And this one here is going to roll his strength, see if he can move the rock. This one just... shoulder barges the rock, starts pushing against it and gets his hands a little bit under it and flips with a single push, moves the rock 5 feet and moves into the tower. But his action is taken. Another one, these ones start piling in behind. That one's going to stay there. Darkson, your turn.
Wait, would going stealth can be considered a bonus or... just an action.
It's an action unless you're a rogue. It's hiding. Or unless you have monk. A class feature that lets you hide as a bonus action. Similar to rogues. I don't know about your monk shadow.
Wait, I'm gonna move the... I'm gonna move there.
So glad I'm not seeing that.
So you move up to where the rock has just been rolled out of the way and the orc's gone inside?
Yes, and make a short sword attack against... Orc number 20.
Okay.
Oh my god.
Mm-hmm. So he's inside. So he's not sort of just at the doorway. You don't know where in the tower he is. He's actually headed up to the second floor. So how much movement do you have left?
I think I used my I have 45 movement.
So you've used about 35?
I think I used I mapped it out, and from what I saw, it seemed to be all of it.
Well, I'll let you get up to him, because that was misleading where he was standing. So I'll let you get inside and get up to him.
Okay.
And make your short sword attack. And you hit. And with a stab, you deal 9 points of piercing damage. Stabbing. Oh, you see, you stabbed into his back where he was busy trying to deal with this chain. And he turns around and you can see he's ready to smash you. You've at least distracted him from dropping this chain. Oh, he knows. All right, Jimmy. Your turn, buddy.
Unfortunately, you won't be there for much longer.
Okay. So we're still fleeing to the keep, right?
Yes.
Wait, I just remembered I have Flurry of Blows.
Alright, make your extra attack.
Oh, wait, I'll just use my bonus action for the one extra.
Okay. Next time you forget and your turn passes, though, you lose things you don't do. So this is your one, and next time you forget, if it goes to the next person's turn, you don't get to go.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll dash to there behind that rock. That's me.
So just go ahead and roll your attack. Yep.
Or your attack roll is melee with the attack.
And you miss. Okay, Siduri?
Yeah, okay, so we're just dashing here, I guess. I'm thinking to myself, we've got them grouped up. But we could be stuck inside that tower just watching them pillage and burn the town. But all right, you know, we're all spread out. We're heading towards the bridge, so I'm dashing. I'm going to continue to dash back there. So I'm gonna head over here behind this rock cover.
Okay, and Soronti, you can keep up with Adrian. Yep. You didn't use an action, so I consider that you can keep up with them to their fullest speed.
Cool.
Does anyone here understand Orcish?
Adrian does.
Adrian does. Fantastic. Yeah. Could I please get a perception check?
That's awful.
Is that in the tower or just out in the tower, yeah?
Yeah, in the tower, yep.
Yeah.
Okay, you hear. I hope this actually hides it for everyone, but it'll be interesting to test if it doesn't, if I type it in Orc.
Yeah, unfortunately, I saw that, but
yeah, that's right. It's the point of test.
Metagame.
Okay. Yeah.
Keep it to myself.
So I'm gonna call to the rest of the guys. Guys, there's reinforcements coming from outside the island. They're running away to get away from a bunch of elves.
Huh, you think they're running? You're running. They're running away, or they're looking for cover here.
They're trying to get inside the gates from the elves to get away from the elves.
So they're afraid of the elves. We could use it to our advantage.
Yeah.
Yes, we can.
Well, if they saved your life, Draxton, I will kill you myself. I'm not kidding you.
God damn it, Jimmy! God damn it!
All right. So, Adjan, do you want to move up with the others this turn?
I'm going to move. If I move behind this boulder here, can I still shoot? I can still see across the field, can't I? That fence isn't
The you could see. Let's see. You can.
That fence across the.
Yeah, it's a low fence, there. So you could see that one, and that one, or that one will be half cover.
Which one, sorry?
Norgra would be half cover.
Oh, okay.
And the other one to the left, you could see. The rest are completely obscured behind Orgra and behind the guard tower.
Okay. So, I'm going to... Yeah, well... if with a name like Wano, I'm going to have to target him, aren't I?
All right, so there's a minus two to the attack unless you have sharpshooter. I don't know if you do.
No, I don't. Nah, but
get that later.
Okay, minus two to the attack, right?
All right, yeah, so just minus two. So there's a quick minus two button down the bottom. You can...
Yep, got that. Yep,
fantastic. All right, roll the attack. Just an orc and elf sandwich, Daxon. Orcs chasing elves, chasing orcs, chasing you. Hey! Ah, oh, that rolled to a 20 on my screen. My goodness. Yeah,
rolled off the 20 for us.
Oh, well, all right.
Damn it.
That's all right. Damn. I'm going to say that's a 20. Fuck it. Hold shift and roll damage. Oh, jeez. I saw a 20. Yeah. I saw a 20.
Generous DM. I love it.
So just before you roll damage, hold down shift and then roll your damage. And it'll roll.
Hold shift?
Hold shift, yep.
Oh, okay. I gotcha.
Boom!
Little as ones.
21. That is a lot of ones. That was a terrible roll. Thank God it was a critical hit. All right, you deal 21 points of damage.
Nice.
No, you lose those eights because he hadn't taken any damage.
Ah, right, yeah, sorry.
That's all right.
That's my fault.
That's all right.
Yeah, good spot.
So, and you've got it, so it's not actually taking off the last one. So you've got, like, way more... Oh, no, that's it. Oh, cool. So I'll just take off the one and the four.
Just five. Two eights, yeah.
Yep. 5 points of damage.
I'm gonna give my inspiration to Adrian for hitting with a shot that I clearly saw miss. Seriously, though. I'll give my inspiration. You can have that inspiration to give out each round.
Thank you, sir.
It's like you thought it missed, but it actually hit a different target.
Yeah, I'll turn around to Sidarian and say, that fucking missed, didn't it?
Quantum physics.
Quantum physics. Alright, so the orcs that are within the gate, he's going to move 30, then he's going to move another 30, and then as a bonus action, he's going to move a further 30. They're all plowing through this field towards you all.
I might be wrong.
Norgra
did not know
storms into the town square.
Did not know they could.
Sorrento, you're there.
Action to move. That's
yes. Right. They are aggressive. They get to as a bonus action, move up to its speed towards a hostile creature that it can see. And you guys are the only ones shooting at them right now.
As far as they can tell.
Oh yeah, you're also up there already. You're already up there. So you still have your movement. You're already
part of the border.
Okay.
So, one block to the left.
Yeah, there you go.
Thank you. And I'm going to hold my breath weapon until I can get at least three of them.
Okay.
In range.
All right. So let's see. You'd know how big your cone is. How big is 15 foot? Is it?
Yes, it would be 15 feet.
Okay, so. Ooh, 15, there we go, 115. So when three come into there.
Yep.
Okay. Or any form of 15 feet, that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
I don't reckon there's enough mobs on the tracker. I think you should put more on.
You just haven't seen what's not revealed yet, mate.
Oh, my God. The reinforcements.
Yep. Orcs begin piling over the fence. these two in this wood gate see that the chain's done and begin to move down here, move into this building where Darkson is. They can hear the
those elves lighting. Seem to be taking their time.
The three orcs each attack Darkson with the great axe.
Oh my god.
Wait, I still have my good AC, at least.
At least, yep. So 11, 13,
16. So I may, hopefully gonna get lucky.
You're riding more on luck there.
Okay.
If you survive, that's divine intervention.
A 16 hits, an 18 hits, and a 22 hits.
Oh my god.
Well.
Ba 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 ba.
Darkson might be dead.
Hey, it's not. It's not that many big dice. Ooh, those are good rolls. 7.
Good night.
11.
Good night, no.
And 10. Roll for 13, 10, and 14. So the third attack knocks you unconscious. You go down in a room full of orcs that are wanting blood.
Well, it was fun knowing you.
I tried.
The rest of the orcs begin to move up.
At least I tried to actually keep you. At least I managed to delay them.
All right. And this orc moves around and undoes the chain, and with a bridge drops down, and the rest of the orcs move into town. Move up to here. These two go behind because they're not on the bridge. Orcs begin spilling into town. They all moved. They all moved. Darkson, roll me a death saving throw, buddy. One success. Fantastic. Jimmy, your turn. You hear the scream of whack, 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 as Darkson goes down with the Wilhelm scream.
Yeah, that's me. I'll run to thee.
Alright. Sidiri, your turn.
Right. Okay, I think we've got, I'm thinking about casting a Burning Hands on these orcs here, but
okay.
It's 15 feet from me, though, so I don't know.
You might need to move up.
Yeah, no, I would need to move up. I definitely need to move up. I'm just.
Based on the cone that Soronti has in front of him, even if you move your 30 feet, you're not going to reach more than, say, one, probably.
Oh, yeah. Well, let's see. What's this here? Oh, right. Yeah, 30 feet's going to be a little bit far behind. All right, so I'm just, I'm dashing again. All right, here we go. I guess we're going to...
All right. And Chip, where's Chip going?
Oh, and there's Chip. Chip is just kind of rooftop to rooftop here, staying close enough so that he can stay in contact with me so that I can do something with him if I need to.
All right. Adrian.
Okay. They're pretty quick, these orcs, aren't they?
Yes.
Yeah. 90 feet a turn if they don't want to do anything else.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna I'm just gonna make a dash this time.
Would not have taken down the bridge, just FYI. That someone else did. I would not have.
Say that again.
From last session we made a bridge so that everyone could get across safely. I would not have taken that down.
No, definitely not. That's still
counting on
me. All right.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to make that move there. Realizing that I can't take a shot and stay alive, so I'm making a run for it.
Okay. You move. You move your distance.
Yeah.
All right.
And that's me, I think.
All right. So we now go to the orcs that are chasing you guys.
Mm-hmm.
And they move 30. And they're going to, for thematic purposes, I'm going to say they can move together. And you can breath them as they run. They're not running at you one by one.
So you can go
ahead. You can go ahead and take their movement together. They're gonna behave as a swarm.
So all five of them are...
No, one of them's going to be out unless... Yeah, no, this isn't going to...
Then ring. Fair enough.
All by one. So for the first movement, you can breathe fire on them.
All right.
And then let's hope your armor holds. All right, let me just roll their saves. Roll damage. So you and just breathe out as a little bit of cinder.
That is the second time that's happened. I hate this.
Oh,
that
shit.
Sucks.
And now they're moving around you. 3, 4, 5.
They're mildly sunburnt.
They are mildly annoyed. Okay,
that's
so
that's gonna need some cream on it,
dude. 5 attacks.
Oh god.
Oh man.
1. What's your AC?
18.
Okay, so only 2 are gonna hit, but unfortunately one of them's a 20.
18. Mhm.
So critical. Let me just roll the d6. Thankfully, it's just a critical hit, not a ridiculous critical hit. Sorry, 3d12. Ooh, this could have gone better.
Is that manual dice rolling a pain in the ass, or is it?
Nah, freaking love it.
Cool.
But that's because I like rolling dice. The window they've made as well. I've been like feeding back everything that they need to do to make it work, and they've pretty much done everything, and it's amazing. It's really good. So you take 14 points of damage from the orcs piling into you. Various blows striking off your armor.
Okay.
Defend most of it, but yeah.
Yep, can't defend them all.
Can't defend them all. So, as they're smashing into you, though, you do still see, or rather hear, some of the orcs towards the back of the towers shouting in celebration that they've killed a thing, and you see them throwing up something in the air.
Oh, God.
It is now...
Can I not...
Sorry, go ahead.
Can I try to get on top of the boulder?
On your turn, you can.
It was my turn.
Wasn't it their turn?
I thought it was.
You held your breath, but they were the ones that were attacking you. It was their turn that... triggered the breath.
I was saying a movement, but it's, don't worry about it.
You can save only the one action, so you can either save your movement or your action. You basically save the dash when you're readying.
Yeah. All right. Yeah.
Someone's enlarged me.
Oh, really? Ooh.
That's all right.
Ah, that's why my map wouldn't scroll in. It's just scrolling you up.
Size of a dragon.
Jimmy turns into a rhinoceros. the rest of these orcs...
No, he turns into a triceratops.
...start piling into town. Some more. And then you hear some roars of alarm. And Adrian, you hear, "They're here!" in Orcish. There's no point hiding it now. And you start to see some glints through the night sky. Darkson, roll me another death saving throw.
The elves are here. The elves are here.
One failed death saving throw. You also take another from the being thrown around. Very lucky, because they would normally just kill you outright.
Right, another fail or another roll?
You take another fail. because they're tossing you around. It's going to be considered one attack that deals with it.
So that would put me at two instead of one.
Correct. So we go to Jimmy now. Jimmy the Giant.
All right, now I got to help Soronto. I'm going to head to there and get behind that rock.
Okay.
Yep, and I'll take two shots at the Orc 18.
Okay.
With my six shooter. So we'll see how that goes.
One hit. Eight points of damage. Very nice.
We'll see how. Damn it, and a miss. Okay, but not a
misfire.
Mate.
Not a misfire. It's all right.
Not a misfire. I'll just stay hidden behind that rock. For this time, I can't leave a man behind.
All right.
That's my team.
Siduri, your turn.
Unless that man runs off and does something stupid, then yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's what I had to deal with. Please tell me I have extra
right,
attack or something.
Where it is,
in a square.
Oh, interesting. So Orc 15 and 14 looks like they have turns before Sorante again? 16, too. Like all these guys are coming up before Sorante gets a turn?
That's what I was talking about before. But we.
Oh, did I skip through your turn?
Sorry
if I skipped through your turn. As soon as Siduri, I'll let you have another turn, and then you can do that before they have theirs. Sorry, I completely didn't see you come through in the initiative.
Quite right.
Yeah, I sort of lost track. I thought you had started them off, on their turn, and so Sorante hadn't missed a turn, but maybe just got out of order with those.
For
orcs
some reason,
or something.
I thought he was before them in the initiative, so it was them after. That's right. I think it's because everyone else is in a big block of PCs, and then Sorante after them. So that's cool. I'll give you another turn before they have their next one. There, Sorante.
All right.
Okay. So I'm concerned. Okay. So that figures into what I might do, knowing that Sorante might have a chance to. What can I do? How can I help them not take an attack of opportunity if Sorante tries to retreat there? I don't know if I can.
Unless you can sleep them.
Well, I don't have sleep prepared because it seemed like it was a pretty limited number of hit points.
Yeah. Can you cast through your familiar, or is that warlocks that can do that?
No, I can't cast through my familiar, unfortunately. Okay, I can only touch spells. So,
all right.
Only the touch spells can. What can I? Well, there's not much I can do, I guess. All right, so I'm just gonna hit one of them with a. Well, let's see, do I even have the range? I think so. With a firebolt.
Yep.
I'll.
It's 120 feet. It's definitely within range. Yep.
Yeah, 100. I'll attack this Orc 18. It's about the only one, main one I can see.
Focus fire.
So, okay. Oh, critical hit.
That's one.
Yay. All right, let's see if you do it.
Drop one orc.
No.
And you kill it. Goes down.
I kill it. Goes down. And then...
A well-placed firebolt.
Nice.
Then I'll take... Oh, I can't get over the bridge, though. I can get to that. Get right to the edge, though.
That's right. So it doesn't cost you any movement. Oh, yeah, right. You're 30, like right there. So you can basically get on the rope and start...
Yeah, I can get to there. All right. Chip. Well, let's see. I guess he can't. That's not going to help him. He's going to. He'll fly over here and be in range. And I don't think he can cast a spell, even a touch spell, because I think he's got to use his dash action to get close enough to them. I don't think he can deliver the spell as well. So. I forget. I do that. Anyway, it's my action through him, so it doesn't matter. Yeah. Okay, so that's my turn. That's Chip's turn. Chip's is going to hang out. He's going to hang out where he is. He's not going to fly anywhere.
Okay.
He's just going to stay there. Chip can't really do much right now.
Okay, so we now come to Edrin. You have a turn?
Yep. Okay.
And it'll be Soronti next, so you're up next, Soronti.
All right.
Adrian's going to take a shot at Orc 15, I think.
Okay, that's the closer one.
Yeah, that's the closer one. He's got Howl of Thorns as well. I can cast that as a bonus action.
Yep. You then don't get to do Hunter's Mark. Just
right. Yeah, okay. No, I'll stick with Hunter's Mark.
Okay.
It's kept me going.
Probably just as well, because Soronti probably doesn't need an exploding arrow in his back.
Yeah, fair enough.
Yeah, that would be helpful. I've already dealt with that once before.
All right, you hit. Oh, you've already got 1d6 on there. You've got it on there twice now. Let me take one of those off. Oh, there you go.
Me being daft again.
No, that's right. And you kill it in one shot. Arrow flies through, thunk. They're just dropping like flies around you, Soronti.
Adrian's enjoying life right now.
I just thought of something, Spite, which is I still have my two prescient dice, which I didn't use last time.
Yeah, you didn't. Yeah, one of them was a crit too, wasn't it?
One of them was a crit. So guys, we've got a 20 and a 14 roll that I'm happy to donate here. When you guys think you have a good use for
it. Why the hell did you not say that before?
I think that might be helpful, though.
Like, I don't know, replacing the breath weapon.
Well, you can't replace damage dice, unfortunately. That's the only thing.
Yeah, I know. I'm wishful thinking.
Yeah.
Right. I can definitely use it.
Oh, that's so bad. All right, Soronti, your turn.
Yeah. All right. I do have inspiration. I'm saving it, though. This is not the time or place for that. I'm going to put Sanctuary on myself so that if any creature wants to cast any spells or anything of the sort... did I just put it on? Yeah, I did. Fucking
You got to change it to self instead of target.
Yeah.
Oh, no, because you can put it on other people, can't you?
Yes, I can.
Oh, yeah.
And...
So I'll take it off those orcs.
Touch, but yeah, I did not put it on the orcs.
That's right.
Did not. I'm not helping.
So I have to wisdom save to attack you?
Yes.
Okay.
Hoping that they don't have a lot of wisdom. And I'm going to swing at one of them with my longsword.
Okay.
Which I have all of them targeted, so I'll take off.
Darkson, yes, you can use inspiration on your death saving throw. Any d20 roll that can get advantage or disadvantage.
Oh, apologies, I rolled that twice.
I could really... How would you treat a crit on a death saving throw?
A 20, you get back up with one hit point, as per the rules, I should say.
Is it all right if I use the first one? I actually want to do it twice.
Go for it. Of course.
All right. Appreciate it. I'm going to use Thunderous Smite on the hit.
Okay.
And roll for damage. Please no ones.
All right.
Hooray.
Was Thunderous Smite not a bonus action as well? Haven't you already done Sanctuary?
Indeed, I did. I'll just, to kind of cover that, I'll just, on my next attack, since I'm getting two, from what you told me at least, I'll just do a normal attack, not adding anything to it.
All right, and I'm going to consider that you've done Sanctuary last on your turn as a bonus action.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, you lose it immediately for making an attack. If you make an attack, you lose Sanctuary.
Do I really?
Yep. If the warded creature makes an attack or casts a spell that affects an enemy creature, the spell ends. So it's still fine because it's a bonus action, so you can just hit and then cast Sanctuary on yourself. It just means next turn, when you make an attack, you'll lose Sanctuary.
All right.
But hopefully, by that point, it won't be too much of an issue. There's only two orcs left.
Yes.
Okay, so now they're going to have their turn. This one here. So they're going to make their attack each. Oh, natural one.
Hooray.
So, and a three. So neither of them make their wisdom saving throw. Neither of them attack you. They just sort of can't get up the will to strike you. And one of them, in anger, because it was a natural one, swings at his enemy instead. Swings at the other one instead.
Raging orc. That is Sanctuary anyway. When a failed save, the creature must choose a new target or lose.
Yeah, so they can choose to not take the attack, but he's an orc. He's raging. He's gonna whack his friend in anger, and he just swings the axe crunch into the other one, and the other one takes it in the side, stumbles, looks to him. Looks very confused. There is a... Where is that guy? Hang on, I'll put it back on his turn. Ah, he's very tiny. That's where he is. Hey! He was so small!
So that's where that weird spot was.
He shrunk! Oh, son.
He moves 30. And he uses his bonus action to move another 30. And then going to cast a spell at Jimmy. What's the range on that? Ah, no, he's not. He's going to cast a spell. Yeah, you're within 60 feet. He makes a spiritual axe appear. A gnarled, huge axe appears right next to you, and he's going to hit you with it.
Spell or attack. Has to make a wisdom save.
Yep. So he's going to make his wisdom save. Boom. Natural 20.
God damn it.
And just attack Jimmy. He just attacks you. 4. Oh, it's going to hit. 18. And that 1d8. It's only 4 points. 4 points. Oh, I don't know why they went to Jimmy as well. Sorry, Jimmy, I'll take that off you. Oof. All right. So a spiritual axe just appears behind you, shinks through the air right behind you as you're concentrating on the other two orcs, and hits you. And now you have another turn.
All right. With my sanctuary still up, I'm going to try, and keyword on try, to move away, taking the opportunity attacks as needed.
Okay. They're going to do 3 wisdom saves. What's the DC?
DC is 8 plus 2 plus 2. That is 12.
So 2 of them make it. The 2 orcs make the... one orc and the spiritual weapon.
All right.
So that's Norgra's reaction. So they both make an attack. Neither of them will hit.
Wonderful.
All right.
Dashing the rest of the way.
Okay. Catching up to the others.
Mm-hmm.
All right. The sounds of battle rings out from the gates as you lose sight of what's going on up the top. Can't quite tell how many are up there or how many are fighting or even what they're fighting. Who knows? It's a mystery. We go to Darkson. Please make a death saving throw. 1 success. The next roll will decide.
this can be close. This can be very... Oh, wait. Okay.
Jimmy.
I'll hold on. I'll wait.
Okay, I'll lean out from behind this rock and I'll take a couple of shots at number 14.
Okay.
So let's see how that goes. I hit him with that one. Should take him.
Well, and he goes down in a welter of blood.
Second shot at number 2.
All right.
And there you go. And then I'll spend my movement. Back. spend my movement and run to there.
Arjun just hears him yelling out, "Kill the boomstick!"
And that's my turn.
So Derry, your turn. You're at the rope bridge right now.
All right, let's see. Some range here. So we don't know what's going on up there, right? Maybe that was a good time to black out that part of the town there.
Yeah, correct.
Because
everyone's so. Basically moved out of sight of it now. There's fighting going on definitely, but who and who's winning, you have no idea.
Oh, okay. So the fact that you took them off doesn't indicate that the elves killed them.
Oh no, definitely not. You just can't see what's going on.
We just can't see what's going on. Okay. All right. Guys, are we still playing? Do we have a plan here? Are we planning to head across the bridge and sort of fight from within the keep?
If you say that, I'm going to scream at you, Liv, get over the bridge!
Right. Okay. If I go up to 15. All right, my one chance to get over the bridge now. So we're going to dash inside and dash over the bridge here. Unless, right. I don't know, I'll leave it up to you, Dungeon Master. And go with the bridge there.
Yeah, well, I mean, you can go 30 feet, not 35. But, yep. Oh,
but if I take the dash action.
You can move up. Different. Oh, okay. You guys made the bridge, so you don't get slowed by it anymore. Like, you can safely traverse it. It's fine.
Right. Okay, so...
Like, yeah. That is your reward for being forward-thinking enough to build a way to cross. So that it doesn't slow you down.
All right. So, that's my action. And Chip does me no good if he's more than 100 feet away from me, so he's gonna fly back over here.
All right.
I can't use his sight if he's more than 100 feet away from me. So.
Oh, okay. So you can't even send him to see what's going on?
I can't send him to see what's going on. That's right.
Okay. So he's just sticking with you. All right. Okay. That's all for your turn?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Adrian, your turn.
Okay. Is Cerante in the way of One Eye for me?
Let's have a look.
Kind of looks like he might be, so.
Nah, you can get around him. Doesn't even go through, goes just scrapes his square, so I'd say that's fine.
Okay.
Norgra's quite large.
So I'm going to target One Eye then.
Yep.
You want to. Okay. I don't know, this might be an appropriate place to use a critical hit on that guy if you want.
He's taking damage, so you'll get your D8. Yeah. And as a bonus action, you can shift
on,
that.
On the orc?
Yeah.
That's true.
Okay, and you can shift your hunter's mark as a bonus action because your last one died.
So. Yeah. Fair point. Let's do that then. Fair point.
Alright. So you don't need to roll to hit because you get a critical hit. So just. Oh, right. Are you targeting the orc or are you targeting Norgra?
I'm targeting the orc.
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay. I thought you were targeting Norgra.
You should target Norgra. It's the big one. Use the crit on that.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's do that. So I don't have to roll to hit?
Nope, just hold shift and roll damage. Make sure you've got your D6 and your D8. And your... Yep, fantastic. Now hold shift and roll damage and see what happens. Roll better than a bunch of ones. Ah, you didn't hold shift. Do it again.
You want to just double that? Not a bad roll.
Extra dice roll, not double dice roll. There you go. Extra 10 points. And with the critical hit, fires straight through down the road, right past Arante's head, down, and catches him right in the neck. And he's in the middle of casting a spell. And you see him choke, grab his neck, and then fall forwards, dead, as the spiritual weapon down the road.
Nice, Jimmy. Nice work there. Nice teamwork. that was a good use of that critical hit, boy.
And there's like a red foomf that comes out from his body and just seems to burn the ground next to him, and then fade away. He's dead.
Eat that sucker.
Done with one big badass.
That's in Orcish, by the way.
eat that sucker. this orc, seeing everyone else been killed, rethinks his life and his life choices, decides, you know what, I'm an orc, and moves up to Sorrente.
Thank you for allegiance for Athena, you're at the wrong, yeah, you're fucked, dude.
Alright, he swings at you, and you easily block his attack with your shield, and it is now your turn.
Alright, cool. Can I take off Sanctuary? No, I can't. Can you take off Sanctuary?
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't have any
Sanctuary for me. So
that's right.
Alright. Yeah, I'm gonna kill him.
Okay. Yeah, you kill him. He ain't got much left. Oh, no, you don't. Oh, those damage rolls you're rolling, mate. All of the ones.
Fuck my life.
Literally anything else would have killed him. He has one hit point away from death.
Can I kick him?
You kill him. Can I use it? You kill him. You kill him. He's down to 99% of his bloody health. He's dead.
I would honestly just spend an inspiration dice just to kick him.
No, he's done with, in the interests of not having another entire round of combat, you guys dispatch with the orc, and for the time being, you seem to be relatively free to move.
All right.
So we've got a death roll to do, don't we?
You do. Dark. You have one death roll left, Darkson. And he dies.
God. Oh, wait. Inspiration.
You didn't call it before, but go ahead and roll again. Use your inspiration. All right. You don't die. You roll a 1d4. In 3 hours, should nothing happen to you, you will get back up with one hit point. You are stabilized. Just for future reference as well, if you need to use inspiration, you can only do it before the roll. The only reason I said yes is because it is literally a character death, so it's kind of okay to say yes, you can have your inspiration in hindsight. But when you make a roll, you cannot roll it to see if it succeeds and then use inspiration. You're supposed to use it beforehand.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
At that point, with Darkson stabilizing, we're going to take a 15-minute bio break. We'll be back here very shortly.
Okay.